probably wouldn't have been after Melo. He might still be out there. We still got some game. So does Jared Allen over Mike Muscala with the Thunder and the Nets in Brooklyn. Check it out one more time. Get a reaction from the Nets bench. Wow. Take a look. Just gonna let that speak for itself. Third quarter, under 7 minutes to go. Nets down 61-56, which would not elicit those crazy faces.
Holding back.
You know who's impressed by that besides John Anderson? How about Kevin Durant?
You have the people, listen.
Allen doing what he does best. Again, over. When was Muscala just going to get? He didn't try to get out of the way. And couldn't. After all that, the Nets are still back. CP3 is clutch. I mean, look, people say things about Chris Paul. You can't win a title if this guy's your point guard. One thing you can say is he's clutch. Clutch is defined by within 5 points. We're at you. 5 minutes to go, regulation and overtime. If you're up or down, five. And that qualified on this night in Brooklyn. Paul was great, mid-range there, trying to get the Thunder back in this game. Remember, you lose Westbrook, you lose PG, but you gain a lot of experience when you bring this guy aboard. And they got 7 first-round picks to come, by the way, with those trades. To the line, Dinwiddie off that foul, pre-inbounds. Couldn't put the Nets up with that free throw, couldn't do it. So with 5 ticks left in the game, Dinwiddie said, let me try this one more time in the lane, too strong. We're headed to OT, tied at 101. And as you're about to see in seconds, the Thunder are maybe the best fourth quarter team in the NBA, which would lead you to believe they're one of the better overtime teams in the league. The longer the game goes, they can hang. Paul off the feed from Steven Adams, and then Paul, the patented jumper. He had 28-6, Thunder win in overtime, 111-103. This is what we mean by late clutch performance.